Are you experiencing a sudden numbness or weakness on one side of your face, arm, or leg? How about a sudden and inexplicable trouble walking, talking, or understanding speech? If so, you might be having a stroke. Hello everyone, Crystal here for DNews, ready to talk about one of the medical emergencies that scares me the most, strokes. A stroke can happen at any time to anyone, and there are two types that can happen. The most common is when a clot in your blood vessels blocks the flow of blood to the brain, but strokes can also happen when internal bleeding in or around the brain creates swelling and pressure, compressing and damaging brain tissue. Strokes often result in permanent impairments, such as paralysis, loss of sensory function, problems thinking, speaking, or even regulating emotions, and they are a leading cause of long-term disability. According to the CDC, almost 130,000 people in the US die each year from strokes. Besides muscle weakness and trouble walking, talking, and understanding speech, symptoms can include loss of balance, disorientation, and difficulty seeing out of one or both eyes. So what should you do if you or someone near you is experiencing these symptoms? Call 911 and get medical attention immediately. Studies show that receiving treatment within 3 hours can significantly reduce the severity of damage and disability. The longer the brain is starved of oxygen and nutrients, though, the greater the damage that occurs. Currently, treatments used by medical professionals can prevent additional damage from occurring, but they can't heal the brain. Brain injury is a difficult problem for scientists because, unlike damage to the skin or other organs, the brain does not simply regenerate. Most neuronal cell damage is permanent, and that's what makes conditions like concussion and stroke so scary. But researchers say there may be a little hope from stem cells. Stem cells are a type of cell that have the ability to differentiate or change into a specialized set of cells that belong to a specific tissue, like skin, bone, or brain. In a recent paper published in the journal Nature Medicine, scientists from University of Southern California took a look at a specific protein in the blood called activated protein C. They found that a special type of this protein tells human neuronal stem cells to change into functional neurons. To determine if this could regenerate lost brain function in stroke patients, researchers tested mice that had suffered stroke. They wanted to see if the mice could recover lost function when treated with human stem cells and this special signaling protein. The cool thing is, it actually worked. Not only did the protein help with survival and growth of the neuronal stem cells, but the new cells helped mice better perform diagnostic motor and sensory motor tasks, like walking on a beam and removing an annoying piece of tape from the bottom of their foot. Even cooler, the mice weren't treated until 7 whole days after their strokes, which, if you remember, is significantly longer than the 3 hours we currently think of as the critical window for treatment. Now, you can argue that healing mice isn't necessarily the medical breakthrough we need for human brain injury, but it's a meaningful step. And this therapy is currently in clinical trials, so it might be that soon we'll be able to offer stroke patients improvements to lost function after days or weeks. I think we can all agree that the best case scenario for stroke is not to have one. Stroke is linked to heart disease and diabetes, so the best thing that we can all do to avoid a stroke of bad luck is to continue the healthy behaviors we know we should be doing anyway. Stop smoking, eat healthful, nutrient-rich foods, avoid high sugar and high fat in your diet, and exercise. That's easy. You're all totally doing that anyway. You've got nothing to worry about. You'll be fine. If you're really into health issues and have tips for staying healthy, why not set up a website to talk about them? No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name, and because you watch DNews, you can get 15% off domain.com's names and web hosting by using the code DNews when you check out. If you want to learn more about stem cells and why they may change the medical world, you can check out this video by Julia that addresses the promise and controversy of stem cell research.
So let's take a little look into how we got here. First of all, what are stem cells? Stem cells are pluripotent, meaning they are undifferentiated cells that can develop into any kind of cell.
Are there any other medical emergencies you want to know about? I'd love to find out more for you, so let me know in the comments and be sure to subscribe to DNews so that you can see the answer.